At their most basic level, transforms will move or change the appearance of an element, while transitions are going to make the element smoothly and gradually change from one state to another. A transition is a change of a state from an initial state to an end state or a final state, which is the object's final appearance. There's all sorts of different things that we can transform, but as an introduction, we're just going to start doing something basic. So here I have two rectangles, one that does not have any sort of transition applied, and one that does have transition. And you can see how abrupt and jumpy the first one is. When I hover over the second box, we get a nice smooth, gradual transition. Transitions used together with transforms will allow you to create simple animations and add valuable interaction and visual feedback for your end users. So let's talk about transitions first. Without a transition, an element being transformed is just going to abruptly change from one state to another, like this first box is doing when I hover over it. By applying a transition, you can control the change, making it smooth and gradual. There are all sorts of ways that you can attach transitions to an element. Right now, we'll be concentrating on the hover pseudo class, since that's pretty easy, but later on in the course, we'll be looking at some other enhancements that you can add to your pages. I'll start off by making a basic HTML page. To begin with, we're just going to create an element on the page. I'm going to create a div that will have a class of wrapper, and that is going to contain another div with a class of box. This will allow me to have an element that I can hook and style my page with. I'll also need to make a style tag, and you can use external style sheets or embedded styles. Since this is fairly simple, I'm just going to use embedded styles. I'm going to add some basic CSS styling to the body and the wrapper tag, and then I'll make a rule for my box tag. As you can see, I now have a blue box that's appearing on my page. This has all been created using CSS. When you're creating a transition using CSS, there's two properties that are required in order for the transition to take effect. You need a transition property and a transition duration. You can apply these things individually, but sometimes it's faster to combine them in shorthand notation. We'll look at the individual code first, and then we'll combine it into shorthand notation. Now, when you're creating some sort of transition, you need to create the trigger or the event which is going to cause the transition to occur. For right now, we're going to use the hover event. I'm going to use .box colon hover, which will access the pseudo class of hover on the box element. I'm going to specify that the background color be a different value. I'll just use 069, which is a darker shade of blue. So the current background color is this light blue. The hover background color is going to be this darker blue. If we save the page and we go into the browser, you can see when I hover over, the box changes from the light blue to the darker blue. So this is the transformation occurring without any sort of transition. However, if we want the transition to occur, we need to specify the transition property and the transition duration. I'll do that now. I'm going to come to the box and I'm going to use transition-property. This is where you specify any of the transition properties that you want to change. So right now, the only thing that we want to change is going to be background color. So I'll just write background color. Then I'm going to put my transition duration. The duration is how long I want the change to occur. I'm going to use 1s, which represents 1 second. Now if we save and we refresh in the browser and hover over, you can see that now there is a more subtle change from the light blue to the dark blue. So instead of being such a drastic change, we now have a more subtle fading in of the color. Now, if I didn't have the transition duration, when I hover over the box, you can see that there's an immediate change. The transition doesn't occur or work. And remember what I just told you. In order for the transition to work, you must have transition property and transition duration. So when I add both of those things, now we have a more gradual fading in. And actually, let's change this color to a yellow. I'll use FC3. And I'm going to save. And if we refresh in the browser, you can now see that the fade is more apparent. So now you can see how easy it is to make changes to an element with simply CSS. This is just a couple lines of code, and I've already enhanced my page and added some animation to it. simply using CSS-based code. Remember that when you're doing transitions, the transition property is going to specify the CSS property where the transition is going to be applied. If I add some other property that I want to animate to my box, for instance, if I want to change the size of the box, let's say we want the width to double in size. If I come to the hover and I specify that the width is 200 pixels, and we save this, when we refresh and look in the browser, you can see how it just jumps to 200, and then the gradual change of color is going to occur. The only thing that's animating right now is the background color, and that's because the background property that we specified is set to background color. If I want to specify the background color in addition to the width property, then what I need to do is I need to specify that as a value. And there is a catch-all value called all that we can add. All is going to affect everything that is changed. So if we save now and we look at this in the browser, you can see that both the size of the box and the background color are animating or transitioning over that 1 second period of time. We'll look at some of the other ways that we can affect transition in the upcoming videos, but I did want to just introduce and show you how simple it was to add some CSS3 animation to your elements.